Hi, I'm Sean Ammirati, a software engineer at Google. The tech world is full of unconventional journeys, and mine is no exception. I went from being in a music school to becoming an actuary, to becoming a data scientist at Major League Baseball, to eventually landing a job as a software engineer at Google, all without having a computer science degree. But it wasn't easy. In this video, I'm going to go through my entire journey to get where I am now and give you a couple of things that I learned in the process that might be helpful for you as you develop in your career or in your life or follow any passions you may have. So yeah, let's dig in. So who am I? As I mentioned, I'm Sean. I'm a software engineer at Google. And I'm creating this YouTube channel because I want to help other people to learn more about software engineering, about computer science, about statistics and machine learning, because those are all things that I really enjoy. And I also really enjoy helping others and helping to teach others things I've learned to other people. So that's why I'm making this page. And this is my first video. In this video, the reason I wanted to talk about my journey is because it motivates a lot of the reasons that I've gotten here, and hopefully it could be helpful to others as well. So this YouTube channel will mainly be focused on educational videos and instructional videos on basic tech concepts, as well as some of the more advanced machine learning and statistics concepts. But I'll also talk a little bit about my journey and how I've gotten here, and some of my other interests have led me to where I am today, because I still think that these things are helpful, and ultimately my goal is to help people, not just in this field, but across the board. So a bit more about my journey. I started off in high school in a music and art school called LaGuardia High School in New York City. LaGuardia High School is a public high school and there's an audition process to get in. I played the trumpet when I was 12 years old and I got into that school. When I was 12, I was so excited because I thought, finally, I'm going to be a professional musician and that is going to be my life. Things have changed a lot since then, but there are some common things. When I was in high school, I learned a lot about composition, and composition in music is very similar to math. And I also got very interested in math. When I was doing math in the art school, not many other people were interested in it, but I was. When I graduated from high school, I decided that I wanted to pursue math, mainly for two reasons. One was, it seemed like a more practical choice than music. Music composition was a potential path, but it might have been pretty hard to get through, considering that it's just very competitive and there's not many jobs out there for composers. But also, math was genuinely very exciting for me, and it was something I was very passionate about as well. I think a lot of people think it's a matter of passion or practical, but for me, actually, I care a lot about both, so it was a pretty easy decision. So I went to school, but I wasn't entirely sure where in math I wanted to go, so I was pretty open-minded. Actually, when I first was in college, I went to college in New York City, the first major I had was economics, because I took a couple of economics classes and I was like, oh, this is really interesting. As time went by, I took some more statistics classes in economics and instead became interested in statistics because I found the quantitative nature of it to be more up my alley and more similar to what I like to do. So I learned more about statistics through schooling and I really fell in love with it. Random variables, random chance, data and averages. These are all things that I was very, very interested in and I'm still interested in today. So one of the career paths for people who major in statistics is actuarial science. It's probably one of the most recommended things. Actuarial science is a field within insurance companies where you help insurance companies to determine the risk of certain events and use it to price insurance policies. So actuaries are the ones who actually figure out how much an insurance policy should cost. And as you imagine, there's quite a lot of math involved in that, and statistics especially, right? You need to estimate. And when you estimate things, you usually are using statistics. So that seemed like a great path for me. So I took two exams, P and FM. P was for probability, that was a pretty obvious one for me because I already had my background in probability. FM was financial mathematics. That one was not as obvious, but still pretty easy for me in a sense. And when I say easy, I just mean to learn the concepts. To actually study for the exams took over 250 hours for each exam, just the bare minimum. And it's more about speed and getting through it all than whether you know the concepts or not. So that's, it's a quite difficult exam, only 40% pass rate. But I did get past those exams, so I went to my first internship. I was very excited about that. My first internship was actually at the tail end of my schooling. I went for a BA MA in statistics. So I was actually in the master's graduate degree portion before I had my first internship, which is unusual and probably not recommended because getting an internship is a good way to test out the waters. And I found out pretty quickly that I didn't actually like actuarial science when I started doing it. So I did my two exams, but once I started doing it, I realized this wasn't really for me. Part of that was because it wasn't doing a lot of coding. And through school and through some of the projects I've been working on, I have been doing a lot more coding using Python and R in order to solve statistical problems. And I was really, really interested in this. And as I learned more about machine learning, I became even more interested. So this is around 2017 when I graduated. I decided to not pursue an actuarial path, even though that was the path of least resistance, and tried to get a job as a data scientist. So data science was not an easy field to jump into, and it's a very ambiguous term. In different companies, data scientist means very different things. And getting a job right out of college as a data scientist was generally a very hard thing to do. My degree was in statistics, not data science, and it also just generally wasn't as easy then. The career has changed a bit. Now I think it's a little bit more common for people right out of school to go into data science, but around the time I graduated, which was in 2017, that wasn't as common. But luckily, after 6 months of unemployment and trying to find a job after college, I actually landed a data science job at a small consultant firm. And that was another great experience. And I was very, very excited because I got to finally work on some of the areas that I was really interested in, which was machine learning, coding, and all kinds of related things. So I worked there for, it was my first job out of college. I worked there for a year and a half. Then I transitioned to a role at Major League Baseball, which was another really exciting job for me. My consultancy job didn't have as much machine learning as I'd like, although it did have a lot of coding, and I was much happier there than when I was doing actuarial. MLB had a lot of machine learning projects and was primarily a machine learning-based role. Still a data scientist, but a machine learning-based role. And I felt there was more out there, and I felt like big tech companies were the place to go. So Google, Facebook, Amazon, these companies have a reputation for being cutting edge, and I wanted to dive deeper into the infrastructure of ML and really, really dig into some of these problems. But for many years, I was unable to. Before I go any further and tell you about how I ended up actually landing a job in software engineering within only a couple of months, going from a data scientist to a software engineer and successfully managed that transition, I want to ask if you could please subscribe and like this video. It will really help me out. And as I mentioned, I'm trying to create educational videos and I'm doing this all for free. So any amount of support you can give will really help. And I'm going to have a lot of content coming out soon. I think you'll find it helpful. So I wanted to break into a big tech company, and the way that I was trying wasn't working. So for many years since I graduated school, I was sending out applications. So this was always my goal, is to work as a data scientist at one of these companies. And I heard crickets. So I sent out every year, at least once, maybe twice a year, I would send out applications to all of these companies, the big FANG companies, and I hadn't heard anything back. I searched online about data science roles at big tech companies because I didn't know that that would be the case. And I read a post on Reddit where it said, hey, if you're interested more in the machine learning aspect or the actual coding aspect at a big tech company, you should really look more into a machine learning engineer or even just a software engineering role trying to specialize in machine learning. I was like, okay, well, I mean, that's going to be even more of a long shot because I'm a data scientist. So, but hey, whatever. So I went to google.com/careers, typed in software engineer, and applied for the first job that was there, and then closed my laptop and was like, okay, I'm just gonna move on and just stay where I'm at, I think, for now. Not expecting anything to come of that. But a few hours later, I did receive a interview request, which was super exciting for me, from Google, and I couldn't believe it. I was just like beside myself. And that was for a software engineering position, which was completely out of my wheelhouse at the time. So I was very excited, but quickly, after reading more online about what the process would entail, that turned to fear, because the Google software engineering interviews are notorious for being quite challenging and hard, and I had no experience in computer science. I had plenty of experience with programming. I knew how to code, like, in my sleep, but I didn't know much about the computer science concepts. Despite all of that, I actually did end up getting the job. So now I am a Google software engineer, and it's been 2.5 years since that happened, but it really was quite unexpected. So I'm going to tell you a little bit more about how I made the transition to software engineering and everything I learned in that process, and share that with you so you can hopefully use it in your life. So what did I learn? So I'm going to break this down into three major things that I learned that I think can be helpful for anyone. I think that these are the biggest things that I have stood by in my career trajectory, and I will continue to stand by as I continue to develop my current role and in future roles. So So the first thing that I learned is that it makes sense to follow what you love, even if it doesn't make sense right now. So at the time when I was becoming an actuary, there were people who were telling me, well, you shouldn't stop being an actuary. You don't even know if you'll be able to be a data scientist. And at the time, actuaries were known for being well compensated, right? So it was a pretty guaranteed, well compensated job. And it was a bit risky for me to decide I don't want to be an actuary and instead I want to be a data scientist. But in retrospect, that decision actually led me to a higher paying job than I could have ever been as an actuary. So even if it was just about money, I would have gotten to a better place. The second thing I learned is that everyone's definition of success is very different, and you need to figure out what that is and move in the right direction. And oftentimes, that's by following your gut. So for me, I had to know I'm interested in this and I'm not interested in this. And I had to keep following the things I'm interested in. And I think that led me to the right path. Now, of course, it depends which field you're in. I was luckily in a field, technological field, that has a lot of opportunities. In pretty much any direction you go, you're going to find something. And the directions I went were actually pretty profitable. But still, I think I had to define what success meant for me and what risk I was willing to take and what things I was willing to lose in order to reach that. So for me, success is not about money, right? It's nice to have money and you have to go towards what your values are and what you find, what success means for you. And my third and final tip is rejection is actually a good thing. If you learn enough through rejection, you eventually will succeed. And by going through rejection and continuing to try, you're only going to improve and get better. So I was rejected many times. I was rejected from Google many times and Facebook and all these companies and didn't even get an interview. And besides that, I was rejected in many other parts of my life. For 6 months, I didn't have a job after school and I was rejected from a lot of jobs in that time. So rejection can actually be a thing that teaches you how to handle tough situations and it will let you actually succeed in a way that maybe you would never have gotten to if you just succeeded at everything in your life up until that point, because you never tried the scary thing. You gotta try the scary thing. Okay, so those are my tips. Those are the things I've learned from my career journey. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to comment below and let me know how your career journey was, or if you have any questions for me, I'm happy to answer them. And yeah, I appreciate you taking the time to listen to my journey. I know that there's a lot of people's stories out there, and my story isn't particularly unique, but it is something that I think can be helpful to other people to understand how you can get to where you want to go and how I got where I wanted to go. And it wasn't a conventional path. It wasn't like I just, you know, did computer science right out of school and, you know, dropped into a software engineering job. I kind of walked and went in a lot of different directions until I landed where I really wanted to be. So I hope that is inspiring to you and helpful for you in your own life and career. And yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe and look up for some educational videos in the coming weeks. I'm going to be starting some of my Python course. It's going to be my first thing. So yeah, and yeah, appreciate it.